each night, and his results have been speaking straight for him.
Well, he will be putting his Patron Warrior skills to the test in this game, where he is facing off against Astrogation and his Druid deck. So Astrogation, he has, not a particularly good opening hand. Savage Roar is a card that you're looking for to close out the game, but that is the card you're looking for to open it up in Wild Growth, which he just picked up on his first draw.
So it looks like Astrogation may very well just be playing off the top of his deck, which really is not the end of the world. If he curves out correctly with his top decks, he can still be in this. Obviously, the Wild Growth does help with that. But like you were saying, the double Savage Roar is just not a very good setup for him.
He does have that Shade, and Shade of Naxxramas is a minion that can live to grow to unspeakable heights, as we saw in some earlier games this weekend. And that can enable those Savage Roars to be assured of having something that they are able to buff and get in a lot of damage. This is interesting. So Xixo, he does play his Frothing Berserker just on turn 3. We've seen this a lot, actually, from Patron players against Druid this weekend, looking to play to the board to contest in a minion-based strategy rather than going for any sort of one-turn kill.
Now, this is actually I really think this is a very difficult decision on Astrogation's part. He could Druid of the Claw, charge to kill it off, and then it becomes weak to any weapon. Meanwhile, if you taunt it up, then you have to be a little bit scared of some type of slam execute play to continue buffing up the Frothing Berserker. So what do you think you would do here?
I kind of like just charge and kill it.
You like the charge
kill?
Yeah,
I like this play. I think that you want to get this Frothing Berserker off the board. Yeah, if your opponent does have a Fiery War Axe, they're able to kill it. But he'd be able to kill it with Fiery War Axe anyway. Mm-hmm. If your opponent had Fiery War Axe, he could use his Fiery War Axe and Frothing Berserker to kill your minion. And you're not opening yourself up to the possibility of your opponent being able to, like you said, use some sort of whirlwind effect or damage effect, kill your bear, and leave the Frothing Berserker alive.
But unfortunately for Astrogation, Xixo has the perfect next turn. The Patron Coin Whirlwind with the Death Bite. He is going to get that infamous turn 5 Patron board control.
Yep. Xixo is going to be able to generate a lot of Patrons next turn. With the Whirlwind, with the Whirlwind from Death Bite, he's able to play the Grim Patron, attack with his Death Bite, coin Whirlwind, and generate 4 Patrons right away. And if he did not pick up an Inner Rage, which would be scary, he actually chooses not to go with it.
Okay.
He decides that he has enough power in his hand that is not under a sufficient clock that he just wants to go with Emperor. And Emperor is able to not only make that Patron play easier in future turns, but also give him 2 zero-cost executes, which can be enormous tempo swings in this very tempo-oriented match.
Now, we see the Druid of the Claw actually does end up coming down here. So in taunt mode, it's going to be the Death Bite plus a Whirlwind will wipe it off.
It's funny, neither of us really noticed that when Astrogation drew this Foe Reaper, we weren't really surprised by it because we'd seen it in his hand before. We saw it in his Warrior deck before. This is another deck that Astrogation is playing Foe Reaper. I saw him draw it, and I'm like, oh, he drew his Foe Reaper again. But no, this is a different Foe Reaper. This is another deck with Foe Reaper. I don't know exactly what the sort of strategy behind his Foe Reaper madness is, but it seems that Astrogation is a big fan of this card.
Especially because we actually have yet to see this card have any effect in any of these games, other than being a magnet for shield slams, executes.
And sadly for Astrogation, in this game it is going to just get executed if it does come down. We see those 2 executes, not just waiting, but waiting at zero cost in Xixo's hand as well.
However, this Shade of Naxxramas is getting big.
Yeah,
especially
is.
Now that he already has combo in hand. If he happens to pick up an Emperor Thorasan, he can use a double combo and burst Xixo down from any amount of life, pretty much any amount of life that's really within Xixo's capabilities.
It's important that you qualify that from pretty much any amount, because with the Whirlwind effects, with Armor Smiths and such, it is entirely possible for Patron Warrior decks to get up to enormous life totals.
What do you think about Xixo's decision to actually not use the Whirlwind effect? He could have actually played...
Speaking of ways to double combo here, he just picked up that Innervate.
That is a way to do it.
On turn 10, Astrogation has the ability to Force of Nature, Savage Roar, Innervate Savage Roar. That by itself is 22 damage.
22 damage.
He has this Shade just waiting in the wings, growing. And it is entirely possible that we just see Xixo just die in one fell swoop.
Did you expect Astrogation just to throw down the Foe Reaper to kind of confuse Xixo, make him have to deal with it, stall till that turn 10 when he can do this double combo?
I feel like you want to put Xixo in a position where he has to deal with that. Mm-hmm. Maybe his thought is he wants to maybe play Pilot Shredder, maybe attack, you know, clear this this Frothing Berserker off. But he is going to clear the Frothing Berserker, and this saddens me because now he's losing quite a bit of his ability to close this game out with fourth Double Roar. Mm-hmm. It's probably important that he gets rid of that though, because otherwise he would be under a lot of pressure from that Frothing Berserker.
But the issue here is now he doesn't, even with the double combo, does not have enough to kill Xixo.
I know.
And with all these patrons coming out here, the card draw that comes on top of it with the Acolyte of Pain.
6 damage to the face.
But again, he still is just out of that 22 damage range.
There is the Piloted Shredder here for Astrogation as well. So possibility that he can generate something. But Xixo now has a full board of patrons, Keeper of the Grove, that's not going to cut it. Astrogation may be forced to use Force Roar as a removal effect this turn. He can take out all of these Grim patrons.
I think that's actually right now, just looking at both these players' hand, his best option. Originally, he was probably looking to burst Xixo down in one fell swoop and end this game. But now he can very easily switch to the more of the fatigue game. Completely cut Xixo off of any card draw opportunities. Obviously, we have Xixo with the Acolyte of Pain, but then Astrogation can follow it up with the Keeper of the Grove. So this combo could almost complete. Actually, it could clear every minion from this board except the 1-1 Acolyte of Pain.
Yeah, I think that Astrogation really has to do this, unfortunately, for him. He could theoretically try to play like Piloted Shredder, use his Keeper to kill something, but I think that he recognizes that these Grim Patrons are going to put him in a lot of trouble if he does not remove them right away. And he recognizes that and does sweep the board. So now, this means we've seen Xixo has now used both of his Frothing Berserkers and one of his Grim Patrons. He is now down to essentially one Grim Patron to win the game. And we've seen this before this weekend. We've seen the Druid player play this attrition-based game that actually allows them to force the warrior into fatigue. And Xixo doesn't have much in the way of win conditions left. Mm-hmm. He has that one Grim Patron and then these just dopey minions sitting around.
So he actually wants to just play this Warsong Commander out, obviously not only to get the charge off of him, but it's just another 2-3 minion that the Druid does have to deal with, which is usually not an easy thing to do. Druids, as we've talked about it many times before, doesn't really have the greatest ability to clear off middle-of-the-road health minions.
Yeah, I wonder if Astrogation will actually just keeper, innervate Shredder here. You know, keeper your guy silence and keeper that guy. Probably not, but it'd be very funny.
I actually would not be surprised, to be honest.
I do think that keepering to silence the Acolyte of Pain makes a lot of sense. And I think that you want to play the Pilot Shredder. I can definitely see then just hero powering and clearing off the one health Acolyte.
But then you leave the Warsong Commander, and then you're susceptible to Grim Patron all of a sudden.
I could also, it's true. It does leave him vulnerable to that. But I could see just keeper two damage, silence that, keeper two damage to the Warsong Commander, and then hero power and kill the Warsong Commander. Mm-hmm. That will put Xixo in a position where but Xixo still has a Warsong Commander left. He only used Grim Patrons before. So there is still a Warsong Commander and a Grim Patron left in Zixo's deck.
But unfortunately for Xixo, he does not have any card draw on hand. Now, top decking a Battle Rage right now,
that would be serious.
It's Whirlwind, that's not enough.
And we can still find a Battle Rage. Cruel Taskmaster. That's not terrible. It does potentially allow him to use one of his minions to clear one of Astrogation. And he's now in like a more traditional kind of minion battle. And we see that's exactly what's happening here. He's just using his minions to try and clear off Astrogations and trying to play this kind of as a sort of normal game of Hearthstone where, you know, he's not actually focused on doing these crazy combos.
And now he's actually just very, very reliant on finding that Battle Rage. But second combo from Astrogation,
It's okay. I don't like playing it here because, A, it doesn't kill your opponent. You can clear some of these minions, and maybe that is what you need to do. Maybe you just want Force of Nature and clear this board. Mm-hmm. He could Force of Nature and just play Piloted Shredder.
I think that's actually what I like. It clears off the board completely, and it does throw a threat on the board. I mean,
The problem with that is that you still leave your opponent with the ability to generate a bunch of patrons. You know that his frothing berserkers are gone. So Xixo's road to victory here is making a board full of grim patrons, and Force of Nature is your best way to deal with that board. I kind of like just hero powering and killing the Armorsmith and then playing Piloted Shredder. Because Astrogation still has a lot of substantial minions in his deck, but he just chooses to go with Force of Nature. He just wants to clear this board.
Oh, and there's just a slight misordering by not killing the Armorsmith.
Yeah, he does give Xixo an additional armor.
Which really probably won't make that much of a difference. If at any point he's one-off lethal, then we can say it's a mistake. But generally, when you're
regardless, it's a mistake. No matter what, that is a mistake. Oh!
Oh, no!
Speaking of mistake, a clear mistake from Xixo allowing Milhouse Mana Storm to come out from the Shredder there. A big minion that can really change the course of this game. Now, the small minions from Xixo are no longer really relevant.
Ooh, this is a difficult decision. Do you use this Harrison Jones as tempo, or do you kind of use it as a last resort to get rid of a Death Spite that could spawn those patrons for later in the game?
It looks like Astrogation just wants to try and play this faster. He's not going to try and react to what Xixo is doing. I think he recognizes that Xixo doesn't really have that much left in his deck. He doesn't want to try and sit back and let Xixo assemble the tools that he needs to actually put him under any sort of meaningful pressure.
Now, will we see a Death Spite top deck to punish the use of Harrison Jones? As of now, not yet.
Slam isn't bad. Allows Xixo to keep cycling through his deck. Dread Corsair. That's pretty weak here. We do see the execute take out Harrison Jones, and I imagine we'll probably just see an...
Dread Corsair seems reasonable, especially because if he does get the patron next turn, he'll be able to kill off that Milhouse Mana Storm with the whirlwind effects that he would use to actually spawn all the patrons.
And now swipe pickup by Astrogation. He still has not seen many of his large minions. He still has not found an Ancient of Lore. He has still not found Dr. Boom.
He hasn't even found an Emperor Thorasan.
It's true. That Innervate, clearly an extremely weak card at this stage of the game. Savage Roar, he's already used both of his Force of Natures and his other copy of Savage Roar, so that card also fairly weak at this point.
But on the other end of the spectrum, we actually haven't seen any of the Darnassus Aspirants, which would probably be some of the worst cards you can draw in Astrogation's current position. You're just giving Xixo that extra time to find that last Grim Patron card.
We have, however, seen Foe Reaper.
That is a big card that we did see.
All right, so Swipe is going to take down the Dread Corsair, and Astrogation just hero powers and sends to the face. Milhouse Mana Storm, still kicking around. 4-2.
Will Xixo find this Grim Patron?
And there it is. Patron, so.
But unfortunately, he can only spawn two Grim Patrons here, and if he loses these patrons, he has nothing left except his Emperor Thorasan.
Yeah, he can potentially play. I mean, he could play Patron Whirlwind Ghoul, which I think is what we may see here, because this is going to because he knows that I believe Astrogation has used both of his silence effects. This hides his patrons behind the ghoul, which makes it so that Astrogation can't clear and get to them with any of his minions. Oof. That is Ancient of War, and we have seen that Xixo has used both of his executes.
That's very true. Does Xixo have any way to get through this? He needs another.
Well, he is making four patrons here, so these patrons can actually clear this Ancient of War. Though the hero power, no, he can't, because he's able to still hero power and kill one of the one health patrons. So these patrons cannot get through this Ancient at the moment. You see Xixo with his head in his hands. He, I think, may realize that this game is just slipping away from him.
Does Xixo actually at this point have any whirlwind effects? If he picks up the Death Spite, that's a good draw, but he can't activate it. He doesn't have a Fire War Axe to override it.
I believe he has played both of his whirlwinds.
I think so.
I believe he has played both of his ghouls. He has played one Death Spite, so I think it looks like Astrogation just going with hero power, taking down the 3-1. And now Xixo with three patrons, but they are not going to do much against Ancient of War. Oh, there is an unstable ghoul. Oh, dear. I thought
this
we had seen both of them.
This is a huge draw.
Yeah, this unstable ghoul is exactly what Xixo needed. It is enabling him to not only kill this Ancient of War, but also generate three more Grim Patrons.
But keep in mind, he does have to run three of his patrons into it. But again, he still has three left now. So this just brought Xixo back into this game. I think that was the best card he could have picked up there.
And he needed it then, too, because if Astrogation was able to attack, he would have been able to clear off multiple additional patrons. And we see Ancient of Lore come down. Gonna need to draw some cards. And this is a rough spot here, because Astrogation needs to clear off all of these. He's only at 15 life. He's able to innervate out the Azure Drake.
But again, this is a big drop.
Ooh, another innervate. That is not what he wanted.
Battle Rage. That'll cycle for at least two cards here, which...
It does draw two cards.
Gnomish Inventor, that's a good one to pick up. And Inner Rage. That's lethal.
I think that's lethal, yeah. We have 11 plus... that is one more than lethal, I believe. So that is going to do it. Xixo comes back from an incredibly disadvantaged position to find that unstable ghoul and close out the game against Astrogation. And we were talking a little bit earlier when Astrogation chose to use his Force of Nature to clear that board. And that left him helpless against that board of Grim Patrons. I wonder if that game might have gone differently if he had chosen a different line of play on that turn.
Exactly. We could even go back to the initial part where he used that Shade of Naxxramas to wipe off that Frothing Berserker. That was one of those games that's rare to see that there were so many decisions on both sides of the playing field, and they really decided the outcome of the game. Good top decks, good play throughout that entire time. That was a fantastic game.
Yeah, there were a lot of really interesting things that happened, but we are already into the next game. Astrogation sticking with his Druid deck while Xixo moves to play Warlock. And Astrogation, this time with a significant amount of ramp in his hand, he has Wild Growth and Innervate, and his pet card, Foe Reaper.
How do you think Foe Reaper?
Probably not for this matchup exactly, but it actually could theoretically come up big.
Wild Growth into Innervate Foe Reaper?
I like Wild Growthing here because I think you Wild Growth here and then turn you can innervate. The next turn you can innervate Emperor. If you innervate Emperor this turn, you kind of waste the value of your Wild Growth because you're going to be playing more on curve the next couple of turns.
But this also means that Emperor lives at least two turns, which is huge. This is actually a very difficult decision. Handlocks really have no way to deal with it with only three mana.
True, that is true. Though he does have Foe Reaper in his hand, and the value of innervate. Is pretty high when you have a hand that has this many high-cost spells in it, or high-cost cards in it.
But the way to think of it this way is, if he Wild Grows here, what's the difference between that and actually using Emperor Thorasan? By reducing the cost of each one of the cards in his hand by two, and right now he does have two effective cards, by each reducing with those one, that's actually a two-mana ramp overall.
It looks like he is going for it. He is Innervate Emperor.
I really like this play. It's
yeah,
very aggressive.
I can get behind this. I think that it's definitely a reasonable play. It is very difficult for Xixo to do anything that can stop this turn. He could theoretically owl it, and that is not an owl.
But exactly, from what we see in Xixo's hand, this Emperor Thorasan is set to live for three turns.
Yeah. And I imagine we'll likely see Emperor to the face.
Now, would you ever actually consider playing the Lotheb just to make sure this Emperor lives again, just in case of a double Dark Bomb here?
Yeah, it's reasonable. I do think that the playing the Shredder here and being able to Lothip next turn is pretty outrageously powerful, too. Oh, dear.
Oh, so I have to imagine that we're going to see the Wild Growth. It is free to ramp them up.
It is, in fact, free. As free as they get.
Now, if you go all to the face, it actually sets his opponent at, it looks like, 12 health. So you probably don't want to get him that low because it does give him the opportunity of Molten Giant and Sun Fury, but he just goes for it.
All right, and there are no Molten Giants or Sun Furies in Xixo's hand. This Emperor is doing some serious work. Lotheb does take the combo kill out of the equation. But this is... Oh!
There's the Doomguard. That's the one he wanted. He wanted to save the Draxus off. But here we see... 8 damage from hand, and because of the Lotheb, the Force of Nature cannot come out to the playing field.
So here, this is interesting because that Foe Reaper is just actually huge. And it is, you know, as a 6-9 minion, it can theoretically even wipe out multiple taunts. Here, I mean, Xixo basically needs Molten Taunt, and he has no Moltens and no Taunts in his hand. He can't clear the board. He can kill the two things that are not Foe Reaper, but Foe Reaper will very likely finish him off.
Is there anything?
This is the case for Foe Reaper right here, I think.
Anti-Healbot will help. He can trade these in. And he is actually, well, but even though he's out of the Reaper range, the Force of Nature is going to end it here.
Yeah, Healbot does not do enough. Force of Nature will give Astrogation exact lethal here. And wow, that double Innervate Emperor just puts Xixo on such a fast clock. And the game ends.
And that was by turn...
That was turn six.
Six?
Turn six lethal.
That just goes to show the power of getting that Innervate Emperor.
Yeah.
It really acts on its own as a super wild growth, especially as you keep getting more and more effective cards, especially when you're running high-end cards like Foe Reaper, like the Lotheb in his hand, like the Force of Nature. You actually can get those out so quickly, so early, that you can kill the Handlock before, even if he did have a Molten Giant, he had to have those exact cards a ton of to get through it.
And we are already moving into the next game. It will be... Xixo playing Druid against Astrogation playing Paladin. And Astrogation, we saw him just pick up his win with his Druid deck. He is down to Control Warrior and Paladin. And this is a pretty reasonable opening hand for both players. Xixo has two different ramp effects, and this Darnassus Aspirant is actually his choice over the Wild Growth in turn one because it can contest this Secret Keeper.
And unfortunately for Astrogation, if he happened to have double Secret here, he would be able to punish Xixo for that move. But without those cards, this is fantastic. The Darnassus Aspirant contests everything. It gives you that growth. You can follow up with a wild growth. It's Zixo's going to survive this initial onslaught from the Paladin.
But Astrogation does have Coghammer, which is a fantastic response here. It allows him to remove the Darnassus Aspirant from the board and bubble up his Knife Juggler, which will... hit 6043, and it also allows this juggler to contest the piloted shredder for free.
Now, do you imagine actually hitting this shredder?
I think you do.
But with the juggler or the coghammer?
I think you want to hit the shredder with the juggler because your opponent can potentially hero power it down. You're getting a free kill on the juggler thanks to that. Ooh, and that's actually a pretty good result for Astrogation. He can now muster, almost guaranteed kill that, and then play an Avenge.
Yeah, absolutely. So Xixo really doesn't have all that many options right now.
Xixo needs Swipe right now. If Xixo draws Swipe, he's able to clear this board and prevent Avenge from triggering. If he does not, then we will see another turn from Astrogation with this powerful board and building up yet another Secret.
And there it is. Fugin comes down. The Fugin. What's your opinion on him actually running this Fugin Staller combo in his Druid deck?
It's interesting. I believe from looking at the games that Xixo's played, it doesn't seem like he has Druid of the Claw in his deck, which is very unusual. We've seen the four drops. He even has Azure Drake in his hand. You can only play so many fives. And he clearly has the Azure Drake. And what else are you cutting to play these other five drops? You don't play six five drops or anything like that. And I don't recall him ever drawing Druid of the Claw. So it seems like he is valuing the additional health on Fugin, as well as the possibility in attrition-based games of generating Thaddeus from the two of them dying.
Now, do you think Astrogation continues to develop his board by using his hero power and throwing down the Noble Sacrifice, or do you think he wants to override this 1-4 Life Justice that came off the muster for battle?
I like just making more guys. If Xixo had a Swipe, he would have played it, and... this, with the Avenge and Noble Sacrifice up, gives you a pretty substantial board presence. But we do see Force of Nature.
This will not completely clear off the board, but it will actually reduce the threat that Astrogation currently has. Mm-hmm. And right now, all we see in Astrogation's hand...
Whatever minion gets avenged, Fugin can kill.
Exactly.
That's the big thing here, that the Force of Nature allows one of the 2/2s to kill the Knife Juggler, and then Fugin can take out the 4/3, and we get the other tree folk can kill one more of these, and this leaves Astrogation with virtually nothing.
Blessing of Kings. That is
That is a great draw.
That is very fitting for what he needed here.
Yeah, that's almost the best card. I imagine Mysterious Challenger would have been a stronger draw than Blessing of Kings, but that's about it. He can make a guy Blessing of Kings, use his Light's Justice to kill Fugin, and still push so much damage to the face with Dr. Boom and True Silver in hand.
So what does Xixo need? He really is going to need a big game hunter to get ready for this Dr. Boom. But I mean, he also has to heal.
He needs to deal with this 5-5. And right now, he just doesn't have the tools to really survive. And this is actually going to be it.
He plays
Emperor, hoping to set up for future turns. And Astrogation, with this True Silver Champion, is going to be able to push for lethal damage.
And there we have it. Astrogation, the qualifier of this tournament, going 2-1 against Xixo.
Yeah, the eSports Arena qualifier winner. Up a game on the qualifier king in Xixo. He just has his Control Warrior deck that he needs to find a win against Xixo's Druid or Handlock.
Now, but here's the interesting thing. I really do not expect Xixo to be all that scared. In general, the Demon Handlock is regularly accepted to have at least a decent advantage over the Control Warrior, especially the newer builds that run Bash. It's not the most effective card. And then on top of that, he also has Druid, which is generally a very good matchup for Druid.
And this is a matchup in particular where the Fugin Stalag combo is substantially stronger than Druid of the Claw would be, because the way that matchup interacts is you are trying to attrition them out of their removal effects, and having one of your minions suddenly die and turn into an 11-11 can really swing how that works out.
Absolutely. But it looks like Xixo wants to go with his Handlock first, probably a matchup that he's very comfortable with, so I don't blame him. He wants to really rattle, because he does realize that Astrogation, this is his first major LAN event, and even though Astrogation up to this point has been playing phenomenally, Xixo realizes he can take advantage by kind of getting on his nerves, just rattle him up a little bit by taking this win here and bringing it to game 5.
Yeah, so Astrogation with not really much to do proactively, but that's kind of how the deck works. While Xixo drops a Voidcaller, and Voidcaller, one of the better cards in a matchup like this, it does give Xixo a minion that not only can put on some pressure by itself, but also if Astrogation does remove it, can generate a huge threat like Mal'Ganis or Doomguard, which we do see in Zixo's hand.
So going on to turn number 4 for Astrogation, unfortunately he has not found any of his weapons. And he really just has no way to deal with this 3-4. So this 3-4 on its own is most likely going to live for at least a little bit. The Execute in hand along with the Cruel Taskmaster will be actually a good follow-up to this turn 5 Giant that I expect to see from Xixo, though.
Yeah, so Xixo with the Giant coming down. Voidcaller does put on some pressure. What I really want to see in this game, or at least in the next game, is Foe Reaper do some work. He has it in two of his different decks. There's got to be a reason.
And we've yet to see it actually ever get its effect off. It stood in as a 6-9 minion in the initial game that we saw in his Druid, which did help him win. But at that point, for a 8-mana minion, he could have actually had multiple things that could have had the same effect on the board.
Yeah, I mean, it could have been a Kel'Thuzad. It could have been a Sneasel Shredder. It could have been a much stronger, impactful minion in multiple ways. But so far, all it has done is come into play and died to some sort of removal effect, which I have to say feels bad, man.
Now, we actually see a great follow-up by Astrogation playing this Sylvanas. Unfortunately for Xixo, he doesn't have Ironbeak Owl in his deck. And again, I've said this before. A lot of the current Demon Handlocks have cut the second Owl. So they, at this point, usually only run one. So this makes it very unlikely that he actually has it in hand already. So how does he deal with this Sylvanas efficiently at this point in time?
I mean, it's a tough scenario, because he could try to play like an Ancient Watcher out and maybe a Sunfear Protector and make it less likely that Astrogation is able to get a quality minion with the Death Rattle effect of Sylvanas. He can also potentially play the Ancient Watcher and then Sunfear between the two small minions, which I think is what he's going to do, and that's exactly what happens. That means that not only are there multiple low-impact minions in play... But that's not bad, because he did just attack into it.
Allows him to actually get the Doomguard out.
Right, he gets the Doomguard out for free. So that sequence, despite giving one of Xixo's best minions to Astrogation, worked out fine for him because of how he set it up.
So now, how does Astrogation deal with this Doomguard? He obviously does have the Execute, but the question is, do you want to use it on something that's not a giant? I'd have to guess that Astrogation is running a big game hunter, so that may leave him a little bit more room to freely use these executes, but that Doomguard is going to be pushing a lot of damage to the face, so you need to deal with it some way or another.
Yeah, I mean, he really is pretty far behind on this board against specifically that Doomguard. The other minions, one of them can't attack, one of them is a 2-3. Those don't really matter that much. But he does, as you said, have to keep in mind the fact that Xixo's deck certainly has a large number of very big threats, and he doesn't want to use his removal on smaller threats that he could otherwise deal with. Unfortunately for Astrogation, he doesn't really have the tools to deal with it right now.
Do you expect to? I think I have to expect to see the execute here. On top of that, he does have the ability to bash his 2-3 to keep it alive, leaving him up, leaving Xixo up with only a 4 or 5 taunted up watcher that can't actually attack on its own.
And it looks like Xixo is probably just going to keep going tapping.
Emperor Thorazan.
Oh yes, I didn't actually see that in his hand. I can definitely see Emperor. This is not really a combo deck. When you're playing a deck like Patron Warrior, what you're looking for is, okay, I want to reduce these particular combo pieces so I can string all of them together in an individual turn. A deck like Druid, as we saw in the previous games, or a deck like Handlock, is just looking to actually get a little bit of efficiency out of the Emperor, and that's what's happening here. And this is actually potentially another situation where Astrogation has no way to deal with a minion that he does need to kill and may need to use that Cruel Taskmaster Execute once more.
Mm-hmm. But then taking a look at Xixo's hand, what would you follow up with Xixo? I'm sure he's probably going to use some type of combination of the Twilight Drake and Voidcaller to come out. Buff up your board a little bit, continue your cycle card draw. You're still in by no means any range of being killed. And then Astrogation is just in another awkward spot. He's using a lot of his minions here and is just running out of options. He has a lot of the big draws that you want to get later in the game. And there's a brawl.
So that's a very good draw for Astrogation. It is.
It's especially good because if that Voidcaller does die, it will pull out the Mal'Ganis, giving you a great big game hunter target to follow that up, mm-hmm. giving you the board presence you need to go into turn 9 and play that Ysera.
I mean, Astrogation could do something like play this Berengeddon here, like attack his minions in, play Berengeddon. That doesn't really do anything. Brawl does let him actually get by this Ancient Watcher that has been giving him a surprising amount of trouble.
He does have to be scared, though, because if it happens to pull a Jiraxxus, then he has no follow-up, and he's just dealing with a 3/15 minion on the side of Xixo. But, like I mentioned a second ago, if it pulls out the Mal'Ganis and he's expecting that, then it does, no matter what happens, will give him board presence. If the Twilight Drake lives, then he will be in trouble. If the Ancient Watcher, it's, again, awkward, like he's been working with before. But he's in a position where he does have a 50-50 chance of having one of his minions stay alive.
Yeah, it looks like Astrogation just wants to try and preserve his resources and hope that maybe Xixo commits additional minions to this board so he can get more value from that brawl.
Do you think you fall into that trap? Xixo is such an experienced player that you have to imagine he knows that brawl is always a possibility. I don't think Zixo's type of person will ever overextend against a control warrior before seeing at least one brawl.
I definitely think that we will not see Xixo fall into that trap. He has no real reason to commit much more to this board. He has a very dominating board presence at the moment. There's nothing that Astrogation is really threatening him with.
So I'm trying to think, Xixo obviously has to play a card now, and the only issue with playing this anti-Keelbot is that just puts him further away from using those Molten Giants, which, again, is a very, very important card to, at some point, or you want to get him down, so at some point you can actually use that Jiraxxus.
So it looks like Astrogation can play Ysera this turn. Right now, Xixo has, 7, 8, 9, 10. He has 10 damage to the board, so with any buff like Defender Vargas or Hellfire, he would be able to take down the Ysera. And I think that Astrogation is going to need to get some serious Ysera value in this game in order to really be able to be competitive. But it does mean that Xixo would be committing a lot of his resources to killing this Ysera.
This is another opportunity. He could go for the brawl, and once again, if Mal'Ganis comes out, the sooner he does it, the less of a chance that the Jiraxxus will be in Xixo's hand. So you always want to save Brawl for a double Molten Giant, really when the Handlock does overextend, which at some points they kind of have to. But then it's your last Brawl. Then from that point on, Xixo may not be scared to overextend. So I think that's exactly why Astrogation does decide to go with the Ysera.
Yeah, he needs to do something, because right now, Zixo's dictating the pace
of
the game.
The Laughing Sister, the absolute worst one for a matchup like this.
Yeah, it is not what you want here. That's a powerful card in some matchups where you might be playing attrition-based game or something like that, or Emerald Drake. The resource is what you need. But it's hard to really play attrition against Handlock, because not only do they have access to their hero power, but they have access to Lord Jaraxxus in a long game.
Do you expect to see just the Defender of Arcus trade them all into the Sarah and end? Or?
I would not be surprised to see that. The Defender will allow him to take down Ysera and still have a really substantial board without committing too many of his particularly important threats to the board.
This is a very awkward turn for Xixo. Again, he still realizes that he can and just shouldn't overextend.
This is another option. The Mal'Ganis actually allows him to kill the Ysera with these minions, and it does make him somewhat potentially worse against Brawl than something like Defender of Arcus.
All of a sudden, Baron Geddon actually grows in power.
Baron Geddon's pretty weak here, I think. Baron Geddon, given the fact that Astrogation can't really contest the board too well, it looks like he's going to just go ahead and attack and Brawl.
So the reason he actually attached that Watcher is just in case if that is the one card to live, he will be able to use the Fire War Axe to knock it off the field.
And it is
and
the
unfortunately,
Twilight Drake.
Twilight Drake is actually the card that lives, so I'd have to imagine the Laughing Sister will be coming down this turn.
Yeah, and the Laughing Sister is not bad here. It does contest the Twilight Drake along with the Fiery War Axe potentially in the next couple of turns. But the problem is here that Astrogation has now used one of his better removal effects in Brawl to deal with a medium board from Xixo, and look at Xixo's hand. He has giant, giant, giant. There's just so many huge minions left in Xixo's hand that he'll be able to use to really put more pressure on Astrogation.
So I'd have to imagine Xixo's probably going to want to use the Defender of Arcus here in order to wipe that Laughing Sister off the board. Mm-hmm. And now with Brawl gone, he has the opportunity to actually start developing his board. I don't think, especially because we saw Astrogation go all the way to Fatigue against Tides of Time, that he knows that Astrogation really is only, in fact, running one Brawl. So he's no longer scared of overflooding the board at this point on.
Yeah, Xixo should know Astrogation's entire deck at this point. And here, Astrogation has a couple of options. He can use Big Game Hunter to clear this giant, which he probably has to do. And then he can potentially kill the Twilight Drake with his Laughing Sister and weapon. And then I would imagine probably play Acolyte of Pain and Armor up. He could play Justicar Trueheart here if he just wants to get something which gives him a meaningful board presence. Though Acolyte can give him some more resources, which I think is what he probably needs to get back into this game.
Mm-hmm, I have to agree. But again, it's either minion here can really actually put a little bit of pressure on Xixo. Both of them for different reasons. The 3 health right now is not contested on the board with just the Argus. But as we see that Xixo does have many options. We even haven't even seen a Dark Bomb from Xixo, though. So that's another thing he has to worry about. That's an easy kill for either of those minions.
And we do see Astrogation deploy the Acolyte of Pain, armor up. And Xixo uses his Owl to silence the Acolyte. And given that he's already seen Sylvanas in particular, this is definitely a play that feels safe from his perspective. There's not very many minions that you really want to silence in the Warrior deck once you've gotten through those. And exactly. Astrogation now in a pretty awkward spot.
He can actually clear off a decent amount of the board using his Big Game Hunter as weapon, but then he still does face down the Lothab in the 2-3, and he, again, is still behind on tempo, which is not where you want to be as a control warrior. You want to hold it and force the Handlock to be reacting to you. That way you can find a way to open up an opportunity to burst him down. But again, Astrogation, from the very beginning, has just trying to been fighting for just a little sense of board control, and yet he still has not been able to achieve it.
I mean, this is really, we've seen in this game, the dynamic between Handlock and Control Warrior, and a huge part of the reason why many players consider Handlock to be favorite of a Control Warrior. The fact that you can simply sit back and use your hero power and develop this huge hand, and as long as you don't overcommit and lose a significant portion of your threats to Brawl, you can just play them out one at a time and eventually overwhelm your opponent just from a material perspective.
Now, is there any reason you would do Justicar here over... Okay, so what Astrogation is doing here, he actually is able to use his hero power, play Justicar Trueheart, And for those who don't know, by changing your hero power, it allows you to use it a second time.
So fancy.
It is. And we actually saw that I think yesterday when Chalky got Shadow Form off of Spellslinger, allowing his Hunter to use the hero power, Shadow Form, and then use the hero power again to do 4 damage to the face.
Speaking of changing your hero power, Xixo just picked up Lord Jiraxxus, and that is... Oh, and he just picked up another very powerful legendary card, Dr. Boom. So now, I mean, this game is really slipping out of control for Astrogation. He may be playing Control Warrior, but he does not have anything close to control of this game.
And with his current hand, he can only play one single minion out, and none of them really contest the board. Obviously, Baron Geddon will kill off the Boom Bots, but that's really not enough, especially when the Boom Bots themselves can kill the Baron Geddon on their own. 4 to the face. And 2. Okay, that's about average.
The Smork Bots get a little bit of a hit in there. And now, Xixo, he has, what, 12 damage in play, 3 from Dark Bomb, 15, 16, 17, 18 from Hellfire. He's actually 1 damage off of lethal.
Is there anything that Xixo could tap into to get lethal? I think he's only used 1 Dark Bomb. So
if he does have a second Dark Bomb, he will have lethal if he picks it up. And there
it
is!
For it.
So, boom. Dark Bomb, Hellfire. Hopefully after those minions have attacked, and... I hope he did. It looks like everything is red, or no longer green, so that is going to be it. Xixo wins game number 4, and we are moving into a deciding game between Qualifier King Xixo and the qualifier for this event, Astrogation. It will be Xixo playing Druid against Astrogation playing Control Warrior.
And this one is, again, I'm so excited for, just because of that Fugin and that Stalic. Like you were saying, that is a matchup that extra Thaddeus that comes off of it can make a large difference in this game.
It is very, very large. 11-11 doesn't get much larger than that. And we are into the game already. Astrogation on the bottom of your screen, Xixo on the top. Players do not, you might say that Xixo, he's just not a good player. He didn't wait for his mulligan. So
you and I could have had a great conversation if these players had been patient. But no, they just want to go straight to their game, get things going.
It's as if they value their time. So anyway, Astrogation with an okay opening. Xixo with a also mediocre hand here. No ramp for him. He's just going to shapeshift and go to the face. He does have Shade into Piloted Shredder. And then he has Stalag, which may threaten to bring out a Thaddeus later on. But we didn't actually see any silence effects in Astrogation's deck. In order to make room for cards like Bash, Ironbeak Owl, which was sometimes a one-of in Control Warrior decks, seems to have been cut from most of the modern ones.
Now, Astrogation actually has a great start by having both Acolytes of Pain. It forces those Druid to have answers to them, which kind of slows down their minion onslaught. It's the Druids, if they leave those alone...
Oh, and there is Fugin. This is what you are here for, ladies and gentlemen. This is what we wanted to see. We are going to see Fugin, and then we're going to see Stalag, and then we are going to see Thaddeus. I'm excited. Are you excited?
I am so excited. But here's there's the execute. But here's a question. Will Astrogation have the time in order to draw into Big Game Hunter to answer that Big Thaddeus that is coming soon?
It looks like Astrogation, he just gets only one card from each of his acolytes. Not particularly exciting. Execute takes out the Fugin. So that means that he is down one of his big removal effects. And Xixo, he knows this is going to be bad for Astrogation. You see a smile even on Astrogation's face as the brother comes out. What did Fugin say? Fugin something, master. I don't remember.
What does Thaddeus say?
He says zap, 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 zap. He says polarity shift is his thing. I don't know if he says anything, really.
Without taking a look at this, Astrogation has 0 removal.
He's a Foe Reaper.
If you play this Dr. Boom and kill off this Stalag, the Thaddeus comes down, which can easily take care of Dr. Boom, so maybe you don't want to play it. But if you leave the Stalag alive, it will trade directly into that
this
Dr.
is
Boom.
This is actually terrible for Astrogation. If he does play any of his big minions, this is so bad.
What?
There's nothing
here
good
it comes.
Here. Yeah, and now it's like... This is the weirdest debate. My opponent has a 7 attack, 1 health minion. Should I trade my 1-2 with it? And it's like, I don't know. Actually, it seems like a really bad deal for me.
Especially when you have an 11, 11 minion coming down. Astrogation doesn't have an execute, doesn't have a big game hunter, doesn't even have a shield
slam. I just want to see the animation.
I don't think I ever have seen the animation
here.
Come
on. Oh, and chat has told me, by the way, it is now you feel pain. That's Thaddeus. And Astrogation is going to feel pain.
Here it comes.
And there it is. Thaddeus. Welcome, Abomination Quarter and boss from Naxxramas.
Also, the Emperor Thorazan is still alive, and you're up against a druid with a full hand.
This game is awesome. There's a Thaddeus in play. I don't care about what else is happening. There's a Thaddeus in play.
This is pure cruelty. So it looks like...
I actually don't know that I've ever heard his attack sound. He's coming to play a lot. Oh, what is it?
Let's listen.
He didn't say anything.
It was like a grunt.
Ugh. Ooh, well, if he could only get 11 armor, then that shield slam will be great.
That would be fantastic, but... Is there anything Astrogation can do?
Oh, it's Construct Quarter, obviously, not Abomination Quarter. Abomination Quarter was that was the Four Horsemen.
Oh, that was. That was where you get the Baron Rivendare.
Right. It's obviously not an Abomination. Construct, come on. I'm so foolish. But now,
and leaving this Thaddeus on play with the double Force of Nature, this will be game over, and Xixo finds a place in the finals of
Here
this
it
tournament
is.
Off the back of a Thaddeus.
And now Astrogation is in fact going to feel pain. Thaddeus takes down the game and the match for Xixo, and he will be moving on to the finals to face Jab.
Wow.
Wow, that was, I mean, it's hard to script a better game than that.